would have built this yesterday. You couldn't have asked for anything more. I mean, there was nothing that he didn't think about. And for me, just the fact that it's a Paul Williams house and the fact that in 1928, an African-American man built this, I just, gives me goosebumps to think about it.
Do you realize that blacks couldn't go into the very places that he designed? Paul Williams was one of the very few black architects that there were who had a chance to have huge, gigantic impact in this city. He had entree, and he had an opportunity.
The impact that H. Claude Hudson had was the fact that he was an entrepreneur. He understood that in order for people to succeed, you had to have the ability to get capital.
Hudson, who not only engaged in making sure that there was an opportunity for African Americans to engage economically in this city, but he fought for us. He fought for us in terms of civil rights. He fought for us with the NAACP to make sure that we had the right to do what everybody else had the right to do.
You can't do 100 years of history in Los Angeles without coming across the fingerprints and footprints of the Hudson Williams.
There's a history before them and a history after them, and it's our responsibility to make sure that that legacy is maintained. If you don't do documentaries like this, you don't tell that story.
The history of LA is a lot more complex than people realize. For the African American community, it was sort of the last promised land. We are very tempted to forget in LA. We are tempted to move on to the next bright, shiny thing. This film will touch on issues of remembering and memory through our architecture, which is also terribly important. I think it will also reveal a lot about the history of LA that people just don't know about. I think Los Angeles is the American city. It's got everything and everybody here. I think it's the city for the 21st century.